Continuing on with our discussion, managing global IT entails globalization. We have to consider the globalization again. Pag sinabi natin globalization, it's the merging of economies. Kasi when you do a business, okay, especially ngayon, no, yung mga big companies, they are not just based on one country or in one place. So most big businesses are located na into several branches or across the globe, not across several countries. And when we think about businesses today, we think of managing them, no, thinking ahead that you are selling the product or services in an international level. So you have to consider thinking of the international dimension of your business processes. Okay, and it must include cultural, political, and geo-economic challenges for the or of the business community. Now, global business and IT application, no, paano siya magiging global? So there are different drives that causes business requirements to adjust, no, to based on the nature of the industry and its competitive environment para maging globally competitive. So first, you have to consider the global customers, so you don't think just of the your business or that business is specifically made for a certain community lang, no? If you want it to be big or to be internationally accepted, then you have to think of your global audience, okay? That customers may have or may can be found anywhere as long as they have an internet connection. Next, the products must be globally accepted, no, of good quality. It can be unique to the country. Halimbawa, yung mga in-export nating mga products, mga textiles and food, yet meron siyang international quality na na standard, no, sumusunod siya in terms of packaging, cleanliness, and so on. Next, global operations. So subsidiaries may change based on economics. So as I mentioned in the previous video, there are certain companies na nagmo-move ng certain operations from one country to another because of economic and feasibility reasons. Okay. Next, global resources. It is the use of resources shared by subsidiaries. So halimbawa, a certain country yung nagpo-produce ng certain raw material, then might as well adapt or doon na mag-come up or magtayo ng operating branch for that particular product para mas mura yung cost of production kaysa yung i-export pa yung product papunta sa iba, yung raw material sa ibang bansa para lang gawin as a product. And lastly, global collaboration. The knowledge and expertise of the global community is shared. So even with the companies, no, multinational and international companies, so kayo magkakatrabaho, you may not be located in the same country, but you share the same vision, the same mission, and you should share your knowledge and expertise to one another para one page yung language and yung culture and yung mission and vision nyo to be achieved. And lahat ng yon, you can adapt information, proper and appropriate information technology applications for these drivers. Global IT platforms are technically complex and has political and cultural implications. The internet as a global IT platform has become a low-cost interactive channel for communications and data exchange. Okay, so we think about global. So it's a combination, a play of words for being global, and then at the same time, you need to be relevant locally. Okay, as the internet progresses, mas maraming nare-reach yung mga businesses, they have to think of ways for the products and services to cater to certain cultures, certain countries, and with the help of information systems by collecting data and the use of technology to produce those results and yung pag-ooperate sa business, they will be able to pull off or to achieve their goal na maging globally competitive yet relatable sa mga local per country or per culture. Global systems development. So imagine the challenges of developing a domestic system. So think about a standard system, let's say an enrollment system. So when you think about an enrollment system, times the number of countries na pwedeng makinabang nun, times the number of universities and colleges na may kanya-kanyang steps, there are general steps na pare-parehas, but still, they have their customized or personalized steps kapag nag-a-apply or nag-e-enroll yung mga estudyante. So just imagine how many systems will be developed. That's why nagsa-standardize din, di ba, globally with the help of certain organizations, international organizations, and intergovernment organizations like the United Nations, the ASEAN. So para maging kahit papano may similar platforms, may similar steps, yung mga magkakapit bansa para yung kanilang IT infrastructure, yung policies and procedures nila in terms of creating system ay somehow maging uniform in a way. Because with the globalization, hindi pwedeng totally magkaiba kayo. Okay? Next, system development strategies. In systems development strategies, we transform a local application into a global application. So, from one app na naiintindihan lang ng certain country or certain culture, iisip ka ngayon how to make it globally competitive or welcoming sa global community. Establish a multinational development team to handle global application development and establish centers of excellence. So they assign a project to a particular team on it, based on its experience in that business or technical area. So yung centers of excellence, these are the teams na subok na yung kanilang areas of expertise, at every time may project na matatouch yung kanilang expertise wherever they are in the world, or they may be composed of different cultures, different nationalities, walang discrimination. As long as they are expert on that area, ibibigay yun sa kanila. Now, here are some key indicators for to claim that we are globally competitive or that we are globally at par with the IT challenges across the globe. No, para masabi natin na ang pag-manage natin ng IT ay recognizable and acceptable internationally. So, first key indicator is the workforce compatibility. So, regardless of the race, religion, culture, okay, you speak the same language, okay? And at the same time, one possible measurement is you'll be able to speak the language of the home country. So, say for example, most of our multinational companies here in the Philippines are American or English based. Okay, then you natututo tayo mag-English. Well, in fact, part naman ng official language natin ng English. Okay, so wala tayong issue doon. Now, in terms of educational level, are they going to accept at least high school graduate, senior high school graduate, college level, or master's or doctorate? And then the literacy rate will be also a possible measurement. Okay, kasi depende sa literacy rate, tsaka doon sa crowd or the demographics ng education na na-attain, yung highest educational attainment, doon sila nag-a-assign ng mga possible jobs na pwedeng i-assign for a specific branch, lalo na kapag i-offshore nila or magkakaroon sila ng bases sa iba't ibang countries. And then they also consider the wage rate, yung magkano yung salary rate ng isang bansa. They also consider cultural issues with work ethics and of course the company culture, kung magmamatch ba yung cultural values ng isang bansa tsaka dun sa mismong company kung magre-reflect. At kung hindi man, they try to find a way para maging inline sila. They meet halfway or someone will adjust to another. Okay? And workforce compatibility also include ideologies and social issues. Again, it has something to do with the company culture and religious issues. So, halimbawa, di ba, most call centers here, di ba, even holidays natin, may pasok sila because the company needs to be globally competitive. And likewise, yung mga employees must be globally competitive in terms of adapting kung ano yung meron. So even Christmas and New Year, to some cultures, usually yung holiday, yung Pasko is not celebrated. Okay, kaya yung iba nagkakapasok, yung iba wala. Yung iba naman talaga, kahit they celebrate Christmas in that country, pero dahil nga service oriented sila, like call centers, yung other BPO jobs and yung mga nasa tourism and hotels and restaurant, hindi rin sila makapag-celebrate ng holiday. So, yun. So, yun yung mga kailangang isipin when it comes to workforce compatibility. Next is communications infrastructure. Are there telephone lines in the area? Is there enough telephone lines available para mag-set up yung kumpanya doon? Meron bang internet? Kumusta ang internet service provider? Yung internet speed, so makita niyo yan. Yung internet usership, bandwidth, the technological comparison, kung yung mga available ba na technological gadgets na nasa country na yon ay compatible dun sa ginagamit ng company, or do they need to import para lang mag-match or maging at par or ka-level nung branch na nasa country na yon yung nasa main offices. Okay, so yon. Next is the standards, okay? So when it comes to setting the standards, dapat kapantay din, of course, international yung standards niya. But at the same time, they'll be able to be appreciated by the local culture. Okay? And then, we also have the seamless integration. Ibig sabihin, wherever we are in the world, wherever the company is located, no, sa world na yun, bawat employee nila, kahit nasaan mang lupalop, they'll be able to be integrated with the system. Okay, so kailangan ko ano yung ginagamit na system sa isang country na co-connect, not necessarily exactly the same. Okay, kasi nga there might be a few tweaks and differences when it comes to the platform, depende sa bansa kung nasan sila. But the reliability and quality must be excellent across the branches on the globe. Next, the availability of hardware and software. So we all know that. Available ba yung products? Available ba yung technical support to fix it? Regulatory structure, yung flexibility ng isang company to adapt with the government, with the laws. Okay, yung mga trade policies. Kasi magkakaiba yan per country. So depende yon. And of course, importante din yung taxes and tariffs and incentive policies. And of course, another key indicator is the security and quality of data. So regardless what culture you are in, okay, data privacy, quality data, and information security is a must to everyone. So we avoid piracy. So is the country offering anti-piracy law? Are there language translation issues? Kasi they can be subject to misinterpretation. And does it have an excellent information content and security? So ito yung kanilang mga possible measurements. And then next we have the global data access issues. Kasi nga while we would want to always be globally competitive and globally relevant, okay, there are also considerations na nako-compromise at kailangang pag-isipang mabuti when it comes to creating policies. So say for example, the issue about transborder data flow. So nag-iiba-iba yan per country because pag nag-uniform kasi, yung ibang countries ang nagiging impression nila, they were deprived of their national sovereignty kapag yung hindi nila mapa-implement yung policy when it comes to data flow from one place to another, kaya nga transborder. So saan yung application niya? Usually sa mga import and export regulations, so sa customs. And of course, the internet access issues. Some countries allow all social media platforms, others they restrict access to the internet, di ba? Katulad ng China, they restricted Facebook. As of this writing or as of this recording, wala silang, or they're not allowed to use Facebook. So, yun. And ano yung relevance nito sa inyo ngayon as students, no? First is the employability skills. As an IAS student and a future IAS professional, you have to have a strong portfolio of your academic skills. I know the grade is just a number, is so popular today, but grades are not just a measure of intelligence. It could be one, Pero ang grades po ay isa also a measurement of diligence, yung kasipagan sa pag-aaral at sa pagbibigay ng quality output. And you never stop learning whatever field you are in, lalo na lang sa field natin as IS and IT. Because sa atin, yung technology, mabilis magbago. Ngayon, first year ka, ito yung technology. Before you graduate, there will be a new technology na kailangan mo aralin. So you have to be very adaptive. And a good foundation of that is having good academic background, good academic skills. Okay, ayusin ang pag-aaral. Next, personal management skills. Grace under pressure, work-life balance, diba? Time management. Yan, importante yung personal management skill yan. Courtesy, integrity, and honesty. That's why we study or we avoid or we do not tolerate, diba, cheating and plagiarism because itong mga skills na to, kaya yung innovation, yung thinking of your on your own, analytical skills, importante yon as part of your personal management skills. Kasi kung wala kang drive, wala kang gigil, wala rin mangyayari. Okay, and lastly, you have to be a team player, so your teamwork skills. Not all tasks can be done alone. You need to have a team and you have no choice but to join the team. Okay, so no man is an island all the time. There are instances that you can work it on your own, but there are instances that you need to work with the team. So kailangan mo maging cooperative. Ayan. So academic skills is a good starting point and good thing, good for you na nakatungtong kayong college and you are actually privileged to get free tuition and free miscellaneous fees. No? Kaya pagbutihan niyo yung pag-aaral niyo but because that's a good starting point. I'm not saying it's the ultimate na pag nakatapos ka lang, dun ka lang maging successful. Hindi ko sinasabing ganun. What I'm saying is, it's a good ticket to have a good academic skills and academic background for you to have a better future. And as IT and IS professionals nga, katulad ng na-mention ko, you have to have the love for learning. Yung hindi ka titigil, maging gutom sa pagkatuto, o matutunan yung mga bagong kaalaman, lalo na sa field ng technology. Ayan, personal management, you need creativity, organizational skills, sense of responsibility and adaptability, and of course, your positive attitudes and behaviors. Of course, na-mention ko na yung teamwork skills. Ayan, developing a mission statement. Okay, so in a globally competitive company, so you need to have a company mission and vision, di ba? So kayo din, dapat may personal mission and vision statement din kayo. Ano yung objective niyo? Why do you want to have a job? Why do you want to have to build a business? Okay, so ayan yung mga possible options niyo to consider bakit mo gagawin yung mga dapat mong gawin. Okay? Ayan, remember the Wizard of Oz, yung yellow brick road? Para makatawid ka doon, you need to have the heart, the courage, and the brain. So, sa Bible naman, it says na you have to have a pure heart, di ba? Right mindset, and skillful hands. So, hindi puro puso. Okay? We have to use our brain cells, our sense of analysis, and sense of decision making. At the same time, skillful hands. And surely, the Lord will bless us always. Okay, and that ends our 8 modules, and that also ends our lecture in the Fundamentals of Information System. Thank you very much, and God bless us all.